So we do have chlorine 35 and chlorine 37 separation. Again, probably most of you know why chlorine 37 is important. Chlorine 35 has a large neutron, capture cross section. As a result, it captures a neutron and basically becomes a chlorine 36, which is a high beta, emitter and also highly soluble in water. So we don't want that to happen. So we are looking at trying to enrich the chlorine 37 using two approaches. One, Bruce McNamara, who is leading this effort, a thermal isotope separation effect. He has a column, which is inside, which is very hot, and the outer column is very cold. So he's passing these HCl gas, containing 35 and 37 through it. 37 goes down and 35 goes up. He can able to separate those two isotopes. He's enriched as of last fiscal year. He got roughly around 33% of enrichment chlorine 37. He's trying to optimize some of those properties, some of those like a flow rate and everything, using some kind of a multi-physics model to enrich that up to 99% going forward. Another colleague of mine, he's also trying to separate the chlorine 35 and 37 using some electrophoresis equipment. So this is the first example of chlorine 35 and 37 separation at WSU, which is done at very, very small quantity. So we purchased this electrophoresis equipment, and our colleague has basically performed a similar experiments or modified some of those experiments that was done in the past to show that in a much larger scale, up to gram scale, chlorine 35 and 35-7 separation.